Now from the WDSU I-Team. With a struggling economy and members of Congress now demanding cuts in spending, the I-Team has learned that some of Louisiana's representatives in Washington are among the top on the list when it comes to congressional bonuses.
Members of Congress have great discretion in how they spend their money.
So, just how much is being handed out by your congressman? WDSU investigative reporter Travers Mackle is live at 6 in studio with the answer. Travers?
Well, Norman, last year alone, the seven members of Louisiana's congressional delegation handed out more than $250,000 in bonus money. Money one good government group says could be returned to the government. And we've learned two Louisiana congressmen are in the top 10 of all members of Congress when it comes to bonuses handed out. First-term Congressman Jeff Landry, who represents a large part of the metro area, has built a reputation of pinching pennies. Earlier this year, Landry returned $160,000 from his office's operating budget to the U.S. Treasury, a move Landry said he and others made to help nibble away at the national debt. It gained them widespread acclaim.
It doesn't take an Ivy League mathematician to do this math. This is like Cajun math. You know, in each House office and Senate office and government agency, if they save 12% of what, like what we have done today, then we could put a serious dent in our deficits and in our debt, in our nation's debt.
But the I-Team has learned that prior to returning that money, Landry also doled some out to members of his staff. More than $100,000 in year-end bonuses at the end of 2011 went to those employed by Representative Landry. Check out these numbers. For the first three quarters of that year, Representative Landry's payroll for staff was about $169,000. The average salary per quarter, about $12,300, meaning a mid-level staffer made about $38,000 through the first 9 months of the year. But in the last quarter, Representative Landry's payroll jumped to more than $295,000. The average salary for a staffer over those 3 months grew from $12,300 to more than $19,300. It adds up to a total payroll increase of $126,000 or 56%.
These numbers are not necessarily going to help.
The Washington, D.C.-based transparency group Legistorm compiled the data.
They can pay staffers whatever they want, including bonuses, something that's really unheard of in the rest of the federal government, the executive branch or the judicial branch.
And Jock Friedley with Legistorm says very few voters realize this type of congressional year-end payout even happens.
It's a bonus. There's no question about it. It's an end-of-the-year increase in pay. I don't really know how to call it otherwise. They increase the pay at the end of the year.
We scheduled an interview with Representative Landry to discuss the practice, but his office later canceled and instead sent us a statement. It reads, "As someone who voted against the Washington debt deal and disastrous super committee, I am proud to have represented my constituents and fought tirelessly for the taxpayers. Not only did I decline my congressional health care and retirement benefits, but my staff and I also cut our budget over 10%, returning $160,000 back to the taxpayers." But Representative Landry did still hand out bonuses.
It's just too coincidental.
And he's not alone. All seven members of Louisiana's congressional delegation did likewise, including the other two New Orleans area congressmen, Steve Scalise and Cedric Richmond. According to Legistorm's numbers, Scalise's payroll for the first three quarters of 2011 was over $230,000, meaning the average salary for staff was about $14,000 per quarter. In the last 3 months, Representative Scalise's payroll jumped to over $291,000. The average staffer moved up to more than $19,000, an increase of $5,000. The total payroll increase, more than $60,000 or 34% for the quarter.
It's definitely very sizable numbers.
Scalise also declined an on-camera interview. His spokesperson sent us a statement which reads, "Congressman Scalise is proud to have returned more than $400,000 to the taxpayers to reduce the deficit since being elected in 2008. And those savings were generated even after merit-based bonuses and a more than 10% reduction in our office budget.
Members of Congress have great discretion in how they spend their money.
Like Representative Scalise, Representative Cedric Richmond also increased his 2011 payroll expense by more than $60,000 before year's end. Richmond went from an average payroll of more than $187,000 per quarter to more than $249,000 in the final quarter of the year, meaning his staffers got a year-end bonus of about $3,000 each. And total payroll grew by $62,000, or 27%. In a written statement, Representative Richmond says, "I cannot speak to the accuracy of Legistorm's data. However, I did adjust salaries based on performance. The salaries in my office after the adjustment are in line with average salaries, and I know that the public employees in my office are paid less than their private sector counterparts." But Legistorm says, as elected leaders argue less is more when it comes to spending, it doesn't appear they're practicing what they're preaching.
This money will go back to the Treasury if they don't spend it. Like a lot of budgets, corporate budgets or other government budgets, it's use it or lose it.
Now, though this practice may be frowned upon, it is totally legal. According to Legistorm's numbers, Representative Landry is in the top 10 of all members of the House of Representatives when it comes to handing out bonuses to staff.